So, welcome back to my second game of the Amiga block, if you want to call it a block. And Genesis has it's a nice game, a solid game, and controls good, but it has a little problem. They try to make it for every home computer system of the 80s, and that shows in the Amiga version, because it's basically the graphics and the music as bare as it can get. And this is a much more advanced game for the Amiga. And yeah, so I hope this will work better. There is an SNES port of this game which has some different levels and some new additional levels with mode 7. I guess they had to put in mode 7 because it's an SNES game, but this is the only original game, and no other games were made for the Amiga. Okay, let's get this started. Unfortunately, in this game, you have a lot of loading time. Nah, not in this version, mods. Oh. Yeah, the enemies take a lot of hits and they spawn really close to the edge of the screen, and if you don't shoot them fast enough, they will just run over you. That's why it takes us a little bit slow here. There should be another one. Yeah. But at least in this game, you don't lose any power-ups, just a life, and hopefully this will not be a problem, because you get a lot of extra lives here. Unfortunately for the speedrun, you have to kill most of the enemies. You cannot get past them without shooting. And you have to collect all the keys, so there are no extra keys. Here we have our first mini boss, which just takes a lot of hit and is really no danger. Interestingly, in the Super Nintendo version, they changed the hitbox to be only the head instead of the body, like in this version. Also some dangerous bridges, because you have not enough time to walk over them. You have to jump in the middle. Didn't say anything about weapon upgrades for now, so you can get new weapons, and you can also get upgrades for the weapons. With the first upgrades, the enemies are a lot easier. But unfortunately, so this exp icon is the weapon upgrade. There's not really any choice in weapons. You always pick the next weapon and you always get the power up. Because you can only get one power up, and even if you skip the next weapon, the next power up will just do nothing. You can only power up a weapon once. So you always want to get the next weapon. That was a little bit closer there with the spike than I would like. This is a really hard part here, because the spike and the platform are not in sync, so you have to wait for a good pattern to get over it. And we made it through the first level, and we will get a boss here. Just have to shoot him as much as you can. It's not real danger if you dodge the shots. Yeah, the game only has 5 levels, so they made them really long. So in the second or the fourth level are shmup levels, so you can't really gain any time or lose any time there. Whoops, almost was a little bit too high, because these levels are not really that hard. They're almost safe spots everywhere where you can just stay and shoot and change the hand for your shooting. Really always looks a little bit dangerous when they start approaching you, but you can always shoot them fast enough. Oops! I accidentally held down the fire button and activated the super bomb. So because the Amiga joystick has only one button usually, they put everything on that button. If you mash, you shoot the normal shot, and if you hold it down, you activate the super button. Super weapon, not button. And yeah, you can hold it down as long as you want, and while you hold it down, it will circle around you and you can do damage with it even before you release it, which will be used later in the run. So you just have to shoot the spikes here fast enough so they disappear. So I haven't found any better way to deal with this thing here. There's no really any safe spot except this left Part hier. So now I actually want to use the super womp here. I activate it, hold it, and it will create a circle here. And that does basically does damage to the enemies every frame. So you just hold it and it does damage to the this part of the boss and it will die immediately. This was actually the gold split for this second level? No. The timer is not correct. Okay, third level. Back to jump and run. And some nice new music. Every level has a different music, and even the bosses have different music, so that's really nice of this game. These plants here, they have sometimes shoot on the last frame of their death, and you think that you got them and they still shoot and kill you, so that's sometimes can really go bad if you're too quick without checking if you get shot at. So here we will first time use an intentional death, because the shield you get when you die is it's really long, longer than the normal shield you can pick up, and it saves a lot of time, because you don't have to shoot all the enemies. It's another weapon upgrade. These zombies are the only enemy I think in the game that don't die forever and respawn. Here, if you're fast enough, you can avoid this pillar, the spike, completely, because it has a little bit of delay before it first goes up. So here's a mini boss of level 3. Use the same power super bomb here again and kill. Basically, it damages the boss every frame, as long as you hold it down. If you release the bomb, it does damage for every frame it touches the enemy. And if the enemy has a really large hitbox, that is good. But yeah, this one is just faster with holding down the super bomb. And you save your super bombs, of course, which we will need later. Can I hit this guy, please? Yes. Was a little bit slow on the lower part, so the guy running on the upper platform was not in the position where I would like to have it. So you can pick up an extra life if you walk to the right. Use the super bomb to kill these, because they take a lot of hits and you can make them fly through the basically melee range of your super weapon and get a lot of damage in kill them. We get the next weapon upgrade, or the next weapon, but which for some reason is hidden in the block. I think no other weapon upgrade is in the block. So here we take another intentional death, because the waiting for the correct cycle to get on the platform and avoid the spike can really take a long time. Well, it's really annoying to do that, wait for that. Safety life here. Maybe not really a safety life, because you take intentional death and you want to have as many lives as possible. So we made it to the level 3 boss, and for some reason all the bosses in the normal jump and run levels, you get this jetpack, and except for the last level, then you have to fly. Do this in flying. Yeah. You have to shoot, or first the eyes and then the mouth, which have a little, very little hitbox, so it's not really useful to use the super bomb against it. If you know the pattern, it's not really a problem, you just have to avoid it. So now we approach level 4, which, like I said earlier, is a shmup level again. But as earlier, there's basically a safe spot here, where nothing happens, except for one. Oh, really not used to mash on the keyboard. One of two places where you actually have to dodge the enemies. And that's the second time where you have to dodge the enemies. These guys just take a lot of hits, but if you mash fast enough, then you can kill them before they get too close to the right side of the screen. So the next part, for some reason they decided to add some rain and just throw a lot of garbage at you, which is not really a problem. This is kind of more like a tech demo of the whole game, with the parallax scrolling and multiple levels and huge enemy, can't really call them sprites because they are not sprites on the Amiga. They are probably blitter objects or just moving the front panel pane of the screen. Okay, so next part is just some pillar dodging here. We made it to the boss. Which, just like in the second level, is a massive machine again. And you have to shoot these parts off the machine before they get too close to you. Then it drops this part of the boss, and you have to get in as many shots as you can with all the directional shots you have here. There's no safe spot at the bottom where you could maybe shoot it better, so I will just stay up here. Yeah. We can't call them sprites on the Amiga because the Amiga has sprites, but these are not sprites, so. Maybe the character is a sprite, and the rest is not. So, final level. In this level they decide to use this double platforms that go down into the spikes a lot, but if you stand between the two platforms there's really no danger. Because the other platform will always pick you up before you drop into the spikes. Get the extra life. Here again, just stand between the platforms, no problem. Just wait for the cycle. Here you have the small ants on the ground, which take a lot of hits, and you cannot really shoot them much, because they're also fast, and if you don't stay in a safe place, they will just overrun you. I don't know how such a small ant can kill such a big guy, but it's a game. More of this. You just take a round on this elevator, no, conveyor belt kind of thing. Get the key. Oh, that was a little bit too slow. I guess if you wanted to and have enough lives, you can do this intentionally. It's another mini boss in this level. I tried to shoot it with a normal gun, but it just takes forever because you can only hit the head, and so for now I don't know if it's the fastest thing to do, but I just stay here, wait, because the movement is also random, so you can never know if it comes from the left or the right. And if you just stand here, you can get in a lot of hits with the super bomb, much more than you could get in with the shooting. And that's it. And I keep the super bomb alive because I want to use it on some of the enemies that come up next. I mean, if it's already active, why not use it for something useful? Oh, it was a little bit too slow with the shooting. And here we have some more of these annoying ants, because after this there's also a stairs, so they jump, the ants jump up the stairs, but you cannot shoot down there. So there's almost no chance to hit them. Okay, just wait for the opening and go through. This is also a really annoying part where you have to get the timing right of the jumping middle platform. And no, that's why I said it's annoying part. And you can't even damage boost through it with a shield, because on the other side there's a platform where you cannot jump up, because it's too high. Okay. We get the final weapon of the game. Oh. You will take another intentional death to get through this. Especially through the ants here, and I can make it just up to this platform where the ants will not go, which is really convenient. You have some more of these bosses, but you can just keep the super bomb alive for all of these and kill them really quickly. The hitbox is really, it's really big, and you can almost stand inside them without getting hit. So here I have no use for the super bomb, so I will release it and take another intentional death, because jumping over all these platforms is really slow and takes a lot of time, and you can just stand here on the edge of the without getting hit by this end. So go through there. This is a little annoying spike trap there, because it has a pattern of two. It goes down two times and three times, and you can only get through it if it did the three time crush. And if you don't wait and count how many crushes it did, then it will always get you. More of these spiders, which is also a part that, well, I didn't intend to do that, but if I already died, then I can use it to get through here fast. So in this level we have two mini bosses, and like all mini bosses except the first one, you can kill it with a super bomb kind of fast. You just have to, oh, if you make it over the jumps at least. You just have to dodge this, the tongue. So we always almost at the end here. For the final boss, they give you a lot of power-ups and super bombs here. I think I have enough, but I will collect them anyway, just for safety. And then you have to jump on the lower platform there, wait for the right cycle, and if you don't get it, well, then just take a damage boost. You could probably do that intentionally too. Wait between this. If you don't wait, I think you can make it. And we are in the final boss. And for some reason, this is not a. You get the jetpack here at the end of the level, but the final boss doesn't use it for some reason. And now we will see why we collected all the super bombs. Because this he has really large, this boss, and the super bombs do massive amount of damage to him. And I ran out of super bombs, that's not really... And that's it. So, let's switch this fast to see the ending. I had enough lives, but I ran out of super bombs at the end. That's not how it usually goes. But... So, you have defeated the mutant planet. And rescued your girlfriend. What else would you want? So, I hope, thank you for watching. Hope you liked. Enjoyed the Amiga games, there are not many opportunities for me to show them. And I'm always happy, even if it goes kind of bad sometimes. I'm happy if I can show them in any event like this.